Okay, so if you're like me, you've already glanced at the duration of this video and are thinking, this is way too long. Don't worry, you don't have to watch the entire thing. What we are going to do in this video is work together to download Python. Now, downloading a computer language can sometimes be a frustrating process. So what I'm going to do is go slow and identify all of the steps in detail. By the way, if you already have Python, feel free to skip this video and move on to the next lesson. Also, if you prefer to read the instructions on how to download Python, there are a few helpful documents in the instructor notes section. Those documents will walk you through the exact same process that we are following in this video. Okay, now I'm going to start the download process on a Windows machine. If you're on a Mac, click here to jump ahead in the video. Okay, so here I am on a Windows machine where I will Google download Python. The first result looks good to me. You will notice that Python has two main versions. We will use version 2.7 in this course. By the way, the link to this page is also available in the instructor notes. Now, this page may look slightly different than the one you have open on your computer. That's okay. I want you to find the features that are similar between this page and the one that you may have open on your computer. If you scroll down on this page, you will notice that there are a bunch of links. Now, the first link here will help us download Python on Windows. Notice that depending on your internet speed, this download may take a while. Once the file has downloaded, I can click to run it. This will launch a wizard, which I will go through. I will choose the default Python directory under the C drive. And then I will continue to hit next a few times. And boom, very quickly, the installation will be done. Now to test if Python installed correctly, I can go to the Start menu, hit All Programs, find Python 2.7, which is what we just installed, and launch Idle. Idle is the place where we can write Python programs. So let's write a few programs in Idle, like 2 plus 2, that seemed to work, and print yay Python. All right, congratulations. You can skip the rest of this video and move on to the next lesson now. Okay, so here I'm on a Mac. Now, the first thing I will do is figure out the version of my Mac. It seems mine is 10.7, yours may be different. Next, I will Google download Python. The first result here seems good to me. You will notice that Python has two main versions. We will use version 2.7 in this course. By the way, the link to this page is also available in the instructor notes. Now, this page may look slightly different than the one you have open on your computer. That's okay. I want you to find features that are similar between this page and the one you may have open on your computer. Now, if you scroll down on this page, you will notice a bunch of links. The first few download links are for Windows, so we can safely ignore them. The next two links are for Mac. The first of those links is for Mac 10.6 or later. Now, since my Mac was 10.7, this is the right link for me. If you have a version of Mac that came before 10.6, you should use the other link. So I will click to download Python. Note that depending on your internet speed, this download may take a while. Once Python has downloaded, I will run the downloaded file. I will click on this Python file while holding down the control key and then click open. This will start the wizard. Here, I can hit continue a few times to install Python. And boom, the installation is done. Now to test if Python was installed correctly, I will go to Spotlight and then type idle. Idle is the place where we can write Python programs. Here, I will hit enter to get the Python prompt and then write a few really quick programs like 2 plus 2, that seemed to work, and print yay Python. All right, congratulations. You are now ready to move on to the next lesson.